Good afternoon and welcome once again. Sorry to bring you out on a Saturday. We had no other choice because it was difficult to coordinate among six eminent directors who come from different fields and all that. For us to coordinate the board meeting date, the only date possible was this. You know, so that was one of the reasons why we had to put it in this sequence. So apologies for starting with that. So I'll take you through the highlights of the second quarter of the financial year 2011. I think overall we had quite a decent quarter compared to the slow start that we had in the first quarter. I think especially on the profitability front, it was a good quarter, a very good quarter in fact. So some of the highlights are that you know, the US sales have started picking up. The emerging markets, especially India and Russia, they've been exceedingly well, both the markets. And they have somewhat offset an expected slowdown because Germany, as you know, because of the price erosions and things like that, I mean, it was expected that it will slow down. So that growth in US as well as branded generic markets kind of offset the somewhat expected decline on Germany. But also there was an unexpected decline overall on the services part of the PSAI business. There's some decline in the EPI business also of that, but the CPS services part of the business, there was some decline. So overall, if you see, that's why the numbers, you would see that you know, the revenues itself have grown only at 2%. You know, that's a summary of, you know, what happened in that quarter. But if you see the profitability part, that has improved quite significantly. EBITDA has improved. It's now 23% of sales. If you see the PAT, that's 32% of sales. That's that the growth is at 32%, and the PAT is 15% of sales, so which is, I think, quite significant. So why did the profitability improve much better? I think there are a couple of reasons for that. One is a favorable product mix. If you take the US market especially, in the first quarter we had launched products with limited competition. There was a product called Lotrel. There was also, Lotrel is amlodipine plus benazapril combination that was launched, which had limited competition. So also we had tacrolimus, you know, which also had limited competition. So we had the full quarter in the second quarter for the sales to play out. So favorable product mix. We also have seen a growth in the branded generics part of the business, India as well as Russia, which again is a high profitable, high profitability markets. That's also another reason. Plus also there's been a one-time inventory provision, you know, because of some inventory provisions we had to make for Germany. So that if you put all those three things together, I think the profitability has, you know, shown quite a decent target there.